Hello and happy holidays to everyone. I'm Professor Nestor Jackdaws with a little Christmas time message. And I hope you're having a lovely time with your family. I'm here, as you can see, an old my little pied-a-terre here in Oxmouth College, England, enjoying my Christmas tree, all the festivities, also going to a lovely Hanukkah dinner tonight to, flex my Judeo-Christian muscles, as it were. Looking forward to that very much. But I've composed a little something for you that I hope you'll enjoy in a fit of inspiration. I hope you'll forgive me if the meter is a bit clunky, but it's my own version of Twas the Night Before Christmas, which it will be very shortly. And, I just sort of composed it very quick. I'm not going to perform it in celebrity voices, which is very, very clever, but I shan't do that. I'll just do it in my own humble voice, and I hope you enjoy it. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the gallery, not a spirit was stirring, not even Thomas Mallory. The paintings and drawings were hung with great care, in hopes that their messages would still persevere. And I, in my bow tie and glasses and tweed, stumbled into the room, indulging my need, when up on one wall there emerged such a clatter that I flicked on the lights to investigate the matter. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a room full of treasures, all sharing good cheer. There were Goya women who raised their cerveza mugs high, and a Titian who let out an exuberant cry. There were Rembrandts, all smiling and rosy and plump, and a Francis Bacony fellow who seemed swollen with mumps. There were angels from Fragonard, Giotto and Bosch, and so many cherubs that I just had to say, gosh! Lovely landscapes enveloped the room like a scene that expanded, encircled me, just like in a dream. At last, I beheld a most curious sight, an artist at work in the flickering light. And off in a corner this creative soul worked, till this spirit noticed me, and turned with a jerk. "Do you like what I've done?" was asked of me, with delight, from this unusual being that seemed made of pure light. "Yes, yes I do, it's a right lively show," quoth I, "but there's just one thing I'd quite like to know. Who put all the life and the mirth and the vigour into these paintings, which today, earlier, had none of it, as I figure?" Said the artist, "That's nothing. A victory hollow. Just wait till you see what I pull off tomorrow. The arts are like water that wears down a cliff, digs a canyon in granite, and makes continents lift. I'm just on the cusp of another breakthrough, and I'm certain my next masterpiece will thrill you." This spirit returned a now blazing attention to the canvas, and despite my own rude intervention, polished off a magnificent portrait of me, which he placed on the wall near a work of poor Klee. At this point in my telling, I should make it clear who it was to whom I was chatting with here. And though you may doubt it, as I expect you will do, the artist I recognised was a dead ringer for you. And one whom I heard exclaim, as the time came to exit, "Inspiration to all, even when one least expects it." Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I'm Nestor Jackdaws. I've enjoyed speaking to you this year, and I look forward to more adventures with you in the coming year. Ta-ta.